How's it going, folks? I'm Des with DesFit, and most of us have probably at one point in time used the Strava app to record an outdoor activity, but strangely, there wasn't the ability to record an indoor activity. Now, you could go ahead and add a manual activity that was an indoor workout, but the problem with that was that it didn't include heart rate. And then if you did want to record an indoor activity with the app but also wanted to include heart rate, there was a way to getting around this by just recording an outdoor sport, and then you could change the sport type after the activity is saved. And neither of those options were exactly ideal, but today that changes with Strava adding the ability to record an indoor workout with heart rate using the app, and this is going to be available for all Strava athletes, both free as well as paid subscribers. Oh, and really quick before we get into how this works, if you do find the information in this video useful, it would be oh so awesome if you hit that like button down below, as it definitely helps the channel a lot, and I appreciate it. So this works just like recording an outdoor activity with the app, but just doesn't record your location. You'll click on the record button on the bottom of the screen, and up pops the familiar screen with a map of your location, options at the bottom, and the start button. When you click on the sport icon, which is the second icon from the left, the choose a sport list appears, showing the outdoor sports that the app supported before, like running, cycling, walking, skiing, and all that other good stuff. But now at the bottom of the list, you'll find CrossFit, elliptical, stair stepper, weight training, yoga, and a catch-all workout profile. So I'll just go ahead and choose weight training, and a simple screen pops up that shows your workout time and your heart rate if you paired a heart rate monitor with the app. And then to do so, all you do is click the heart rate icon, and here's where you can pair a Bluetooth heart rate strap. And if you need some recommendations on a budget heart rate monitor, I'll have a link down in the description below where I went over some really good options. But then all you do is just press start, and then away you go with your workout. When you're recording, you can move between the Strava app and other apps, no problem, and you can lock your screen and it still records in the background. When you're done with your activity, you simply press stop, and then you have the option of resuming the workout or ending it. When you click finish, you'll then enter a title for your workout, then you have all the normal stuff like adding photos, adding a description, and entering your perceived exertion. You can still change the activity type if you'd like to at this point, and then you can set your privacy of the activity. Oh, and then you can also discard it at the bottom. And once you save it, now you have that activity all ready to go, where it gives your workout time, average heart rate, max heart rate, and then you can dive in and see the normal heart rate graph and the heart rate zones that you normally see when you have heart rate information. So the ability to record an indoor workout with the Strava app is really neat and all, but I did notice a couple things. So if you notice, it has running and cycling as outdoor workout profiles up top, but running and cycling aren't listed below that in the indoor workout profiles. So if you click on run or ride, it's the same as before, where it automatically enables GPS to record your location, and there doesn't seem to be a way to toggle this on or off in settings. So if you're running on a treadmill or cycling indoors, you may just have to use that standard workout activity profile for the moment and then change the sport type after you've saved your activity. But I think it would be a lot better if you could just click run or ride, and then it will have a little toggle to enable or disable GPS for an indoor versus an outdoor activity. I was on the beta version of the app, so this very well could change in the future, but I just thought I'd go ahead and mention it. Anyhow, that's just a quick look at the newly added ability to record indoor workouts with heart rate using the Strava app, and this rolls out to all users as of today. And if you found this video useful or informative, make sure to hit that like button down below, and also subscribe to the channel for plenty more sports tech videos that are coming soon. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.